Welcome back to part 4 of Firewatch. About to start day 2. Hopefully we can find whoever ransacked our tower.
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Hey, good first day.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Gotta go back to the cave. And then we gotta go north. I'm not gonna lie, I was not paying attention. Wonder who cut the power lines though. Seems a little sus. Dang, we really do just leap off there, don't we?
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
Bucket!
I don't know. I used to just spend a lot of time with our dog, Bucket.
Aw, that's a good name.
He was a good dog.
What type?
A beagle. We got him from the pound.
That's great. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you?
That sounds a little suspicious.
All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Bucket's a cute name. You owned him with someone?
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife? Or like she's taken half my stuff, wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
So many paths. Oh my goodness. Looks promising. Another outhouse.
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Refrain. I'm headed off to Old Shoshone, where the birds and the bees won't know me, where men and the war don't exist no more, and there ain't no gals to keep no score. I'm taking off for the woods to a place where there ain't no shoulds, don't need no books, I'll ponder the ponderosas, don't need no lady, I'll marry the mariposas. Can't wait no time in getting there. Oh, can't waste no time in getting there. I'll do AD down AD without a prayer. Don't need no gal, I'll spruce up for the spruces. Don't need no pal, I'll change my mood for the mooses.
You don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
Well, we'll see how this goes.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Why do you think they'd be up here?
Hell if I know, but they better have stayed away from our communication stuff.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
Follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
Just like tiny black clouds are rigging me out.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
That's actually good to hear. I can send someone out to fix it. Good find.
Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Not sure where I'm going, but I haven't found a cane in the hot sec, so... guess we'll go down this way... and head back south. Seems fair.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
I don't like that.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just... leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
Rebel.
Was he a ranger or something?
Oh, no. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned, and one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
One, two, three, four. Oh. Guess who's going out with Debbie next week? Not that Steve. It's your man Ron. I went up to check out the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself more than usual. So I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in the hammock? I'm starting to think that Forest Service only picks the deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're on the creme de la creme. Let's toast Deb at the spot. Ron. Loose stone. Fossilized claw.
She's got Alzheimer's, like, dementia.
is she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in the fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there, as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail.
Oak tree.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
Hey, flapjack. And that used to be a show. The Misadventures of Flapjack. Rapple. I think we gotta follow this river. A rebel. Nope. Feel like we've been here before. We have. This is the way, or like right near the lake. Stupid kids.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk.
We've all been there.
Hey, do you see that?
No, but maybe. See what, exactly?
I can barely make it out. But there's a small wisp of smoke way down to the southwest. You should be able to find a way over there from the meadow by the lake. Towards Five Mile Creek, it's in the southwest quadrant of your map.
What, you think it's those girls?
I'm pretty sure it's a campfire, so yeah. I'd call that a safe bet.
Man, they really do not give a shit, do they?
Not a one.
Oh, hello? Oh my god, I'm stupid.
Okay, I have eyes on that smoke plume.
Great! Find your way over there and give them hell.
This way. Maybe? Check the map! Okay, so yeah, I gotta keep going. It's corn. Guess I'll wear this fair.
What are you gonna do when the fire season wraps up? Are you gonna go be with her? Just go back to Boulder?
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents... I think they always thought she could do better. And... that I...
Mitch Michaels, 31, 6'2", 165, short brown. Was last seen around Jonesy Lake on July 3rd. He was first reported missing July 29th. That was a long time. By service personnel, he is not known to be familiar with the area.
I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it. Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Uh-oh.
It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
Alright, yeah, we're in the right area.
Campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder. Which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear, or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but...
Dear Psycho, I hope you're happy. We're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us at the lake. And then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing panties is gross. You're probably a mental axe murderer and so are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks.
Even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
How can you tell?
The girls left someone, me, I guess, a note.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
I didn't do anything to them, but it looks like someone had it out for them.
Then why do they think it's you?
Fuck, I don't know.
Huh.
Hey, I don't.
I believe you. Come on, Henry.
All right, it's just, it's weird what happened out here.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.